She is Australia's craft queen, who had lots of fun creating with the one and only Bert Newton on Good Morning Australia.
And tie them together. Probably raffia is the best bit.
Yeah.
Very simple. And then find a nice dark spot away from light and hang those up somewhere for a couple of weeks to dry. Now, you think that's funny,
I can tell. No, I'm just thinking. Ray Martin does a two-hour special with Olivia Newton-John. I'm sitting here holding D-thorn roses.
Well, it could be a gerbera.
Well, that's right. Oh, look at that.
And what they'll end up looking like is probably something like that. Now, they were pink ones.
Yeah.
But.
Oh, I'm sorry, I beg your pardon. The wrong reaction. Let's try that again.
Right,
so, say that again.
What they'll end up looking like is.
Oh,
something
aren't
like
they
that.
Wonderful?
Well, Tonia Todman's next crafting move is as a guest judge on Making It Australia, and she joins us now from country Victoria. It is so gorgeous to see you, Tonia. They were great days. Good fun working with Bert on Good Morning Australia.
It was a wonderful time of my life. It really was. And Bert, such a delight. Look, he's unique. There's nothing else I could say. He's a one and only, and I love him dearly.
Oh, great. It always looked like fun and unpredictable in its nature, but what are some of your fondest memories from the show?
Oh, look, I belly danced. That was something I never thought anyone would convince me to. This is a mock doll that completely confused Bert. He had no idea what I was doing. No idea at all. And I'm probably pleased to say that not many were made. It was very heavy. If any child had thrown it at another child, they'd probably have knocked it unconscious. But never mind. Bert was always good for a joke. And believe me, there are a lot of jokes about what I did because largely he couldn't really understand why I needed to make this stuff and what its purpose was. But we shared a sense of humour, and that was very important.
Have you kept in touch with him?
Oh, off and on. He's a very private man, very private, and his family are very close to him. And I think he's very happy in his retirement. And so, yes, if I saw him in the street, we'd have a coffee and a hug, and that'd probably be it. Yes. Yeah.
Such an enormous talent. But as are you in your career, you've authored 28 crafting books, graced our television screens, influenced style magazines, and inspired Aussies around the country to get creative. What is it that makes this your passion? Why do you love crafting?
Look, at my accident, I suspect, Angela. I've always felt that being creative was a natural thing. It's as natural to me as breathing. And I don't see it as any particular skill. I love the fact that I can teach other people to do it. And I really love the fact that they like what I'm doing. That's very important. Creativity is just one of those essential humanities, as far as I'm concerned. It's something that is innate in everybody, and it just needs to be brought out. It brings out the confidence in kids. It teaches people to excel where they didn't think they could. And the confidence it brings to people is just worthwhile.
Oh, most definitely does, for sure. Now, Tonia, while your career has, for the most part, been upbeat, life hasn't always been easy all the time. In fact, in 2018, you went through the unimaginable and lost your home in a devastating fire. What was that time like for you?
I'm not allowed to swear on television, but it was pretty terrible.
Yeah.
We had a lot of... it was an historic bluestone. This was just a little addition, but we lost everything, Tristan, and it was a very unfortunate incident because while we were adequately insured, our insurer demolished the house and put in place a builder who'd never built a house before. So we've had an almighty effort. It's now nearly 4 years later, and we're still struggling because a lot of it now, the new building, has to be pulled down and rebuilt, which all I can say is bring on the Insurance Royal Commission. That's really what I'd like to say.
How have you overcome the tragedy? How did you keep yourself moving forward?
Oh, Angela, tried very hard. I've got a darling husband who's, apart from many things, he's a psychologist, and so he's kept me on the straight and level, but, he thinks he has. I'm pretty sure I'm not. I'm fairly certain I'm off balance somewhere. But look, we can only have hope. And I've turned to the garden. The garden was wrecked by all the 16 fire brigades pouring that smoke in, you know, the fire inhibitor, that pink stuff that kills everything. Yep. Yeah, well, we had a pink garden for a long while. And so it was an historic old house. It was a heritage listed. It's 1860 and very much part of the Macedon Rangers history. And so we've just had to focus on staying alive.
Yeah.
Well, that's what can you do? Yeah. Staying alive is about all you can do when you're in the hands of someone else. When your life is in the control of other people and you can't really tell those other people what to do, you're between a rock and a hard place, as they say in Australia. You know, it's difficult.
Well, that's it, yeah. But you've made it true, which is great. And you're back. You're getting back now to your crafting and television roots as a guest judge on Making It Australia. I absolutely love this show. What can fans expect? What can fans expect to see from you on the show? I'd imagine it was lots of fun.
Oh, well, a rather bewildered lady when she walked into that wonderful barn, pretty overwhelmed by the amazing things that the competitors were making. Their imaginations are extraordinary. That's all I can say. They just excel themselves, and I think viewers will gain a lot by seeing the interpretations of a simple premise, you know, make something for someone you love or whatever, and the results are astonishing. Now, what I'm showing you there is the all-famous Hessian mouse, which will go to my grave, I think. I think I made one in a shearing shed about 35 years ago, and I keep being told about these Hessian mice. They're pretty awful, really. They're pretty awful. But of all the things, in 19 years of doing this on television, of all the years they asked, of all the things they asked me to do was make a wretched Hessian mouse. So more mice.
Oh, great.
But you will enjoy the show. It's family friendly. It's something that the kids will get inspired by. There's no doubt about that.
For
sure.
And
if you're a crafter, you'll get ideas and you'll get some concepts that you will never have thought of. Because what we're doing is bringing out a very unique assortment, if you like, of talent, and I think that's important. It's never been done in Australia. Channel 10 can be very proud of the show.
I think that
anyone who tunes in will love it.
Well, that's it. Our family is reaping the benefits of it. Tonia, it's been great to speak to you and catch up. Don't miss Tonia Todman on Making It Australia tomorrow night at 6 p.m. on 10 and 10 Play on Demand. All the best, Tonia. Great to see you smiling.
Great to see
you. Thank you. Lovely to be here. Hope to see you again.
We will, of course. Take care.